In this video presentation, I am going to show you how to use the T-test function on the TI-83 calculator in order to compute the test statistic as well as determine the p-value. So let's explore an example. In a publication published early this year, the average amount of water used per day per person was 123 gallons. A water conservationist believes he uses less water per day and would like to test his theory. He samples 25 days and determines the average amount of water used to be 111 gallons with a standard deviation of 24 gallons. At the 1% level of significance, is there sufficient evidence to support the water conservationist theory? To use the calculator to compute the test statistic as well as the p-value, you're first going to press stat, use the right arrow key to highlight tests, and select number 2 for t-test. On this screen, you have two options. You can enter the data or you can enter the summary statistics. Since we have the summary statistics, I'm going to use the right arrow key to highlight stats and press enter. Next, I'm going to enter the value of the null hypothesis, and for this example, it was 123. The sample mean was 111. The standard deviation was 24, and the sample size was 25. Next, we'll need to enter the direction of the alternative hypothesis, and the researcher for this problem wanted to determine if he used less water per day than what was published in the publication. So the alternative is less than, which is the second option. So I'm going to use the right arrow key to highlight the second option and press enter, go to calculate, press enter, and on this next screen you'll see the value of the test statistic as well as the p-value. Since the p-value is less than alpha, then we have enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis.